What's the best food to eat when you're scared? Ice cream.
What's up, everyone? In this video, I'm going to be ranking all five Scream films, worst to best. I'm going to try to do it very fast so I can keep your attention. So, let's go. So, coming in last place is going to be Scream 3. No really big surprise. I just don't really like how unrealistic it is. Just with the voice changer and with that one scene with the entire house exploding. It's very unrealistic. And plus, it's set in Hollywood, which I don't really like that. I like it when it's set in a smaller town, like a college campus, stuff like that, just because it's more relatable. Also, it can be quite goofy at times, and it doesn't really take itself too seriously, and it's really not that scary. Not a terrible movie, but it's definitely my least favorite out of the franchise. Next up, I have Scream 4. It's definitely better and scarier than Scream 3, but I just don't really like the cinematography or the color palette in this movie. And I mean, that's not a huge problem, but the biggest problem is just I don't really like the characters. A lot of them are kind of forgettable, in my opinion. And the killers, I mean, they're all right. They're not like super memorable or anything, but for the movie, I thought they're okay. But like I said, not a horrible movie or anything. I still enjoy rewatching it. And I like most of the kills are pretty brutal. And this movie is also filmed in Michigan, which is where I'm from. So that's pretty cool. Next up is Scream 2. Now, occasionally I like Scream 4 more than I do Scream 2, but today I like Scream 2 more than I do Scream 4. Mostly just because the opening to this movie is just so good. I love the opening. It's amazing. It's like I've never seen anything like it before, so I gotta give it that. And I still like most of the characters in this movie are more memorable than Scream 4 characters, and the killers are definitely better in my opinion. And also, this movie took a huge risk with killing Randy, which I thought that was pretty cool that the movie had the balls to do that. Because Scream 4 and Scream 3 don't really take any like major risk. There's like no scenes where I'm like, oh my gosh, did they actually just do that? But Scream 2 like was pretty surprising. I wouldn't expect that they. Sorry, guys, it's like 3 in the morning. I'm stumbling, mumbling a lot. Yeah, I'm just hoping I can get this video out to get some views, but I don't know. What am I even saying? Anyways, back to Scream 2. There, I do have some negatives with this movie. One, it's a little too goofy like Scream 3. I think this is the least scariest Scream out of the entire franchise for me. Scream 3 had that like scene with the dead mom and like her like come back to life and stuff. I always found that a little scary when I watched it a long time ago. It's a little goofy now, but I still find it a little creepy. This movie is not, I don't really find any scenes like really terrifying or super spooky or anything, but that's just me. And the ending, I like the killers, but the whole foam blocks and this auditorium setting, I don't really like it. It was too goofy for me. Coming in second place is going to be Scream 5. I'm not really sure if this is an unpopular opinion yet, because I'm not really sure what the general audience thinks of Scream 5, but I really enjoyed it. I thought all the characters were good. I liked the killers. Not great or anything, but I still thought they were entertaining. It was really cool to go back to Stu's old house. Oh, that was really cool to see. And then just to see Sydney, Gale, and Dewey again. And plus, like I said, the new characters, I thought all of them were good too. The only thing I didn't like about this movie is I feel like when they were like questioning each other, like they were way too serious about that. What I like about the original was it's just, they were kind of just joking around with it, but like in this movie, like they actually get like offended, like, how could you think I'm the killer? And then one of them like gets mad and leave. Like, I feel like they took that a bit too far, and I don't really like the way, I feel like the way Dewey died could have been handled a little bit better, like, because Dewey was a little dumb in that situation. Like, he was like, first off, he didn't unmask the killer when he knocked him out, and then he went back alone. Like, that was little, come on, really. And then also, I feel like there's a bit too many close-ups in this movie. Like, what I like about the original as well is there's, like, a lot of wide shots, and there's not a lot of shaky cam. There's a lot of shaky cam and a lot of close-ups, which I don't really like. I like to see the location in the background a bit more, but that's just a couple nitpicks I have. Overall, I thought it was a good movie. It surprised me, and yeah, but that leads us to number one. Coming to number one is Ice Cream. Okay, Scream, I don't think anyone's surprised by that. But I love this movie. I think it's very good. I love the killers. I love Billy and Stu. I mean, those two are amazing in my book. I think Kevin Williamson made some amazing characters, and then Wes Craven did a phenomenal job directing. And plus, the opening scene was amazing. But my favorite scene in the movie is just the ending with Billy, Stu, and Sydney just fighting with each other. I thought that was really good, and I just loved rewatching that scene. But yeah, it's an amazing movie, one of my favorite movies of all time. Hope you guys enjoyed this ranking video. Let me know your ranking in the comments below, and yeah, have a good day. Goodbye.